Irregular patterns can be difficult to create, often requiring two or more pattern features or delete face features. Now, when creating linear, circular, and curved pattern features, this process is much easier. Rather than trying to think of ways to make your models more robust and keep your feature count low, simply add all the holes at the minimum spacing and use skip instances to remove the ones you don't need. Each instance is highlighted with a point, and you can either click each one individually or box select multiple points at once. To edit your selections, click the points on screen or click the X in the dialog next to the instance number. For a linear pattern in two directions, skipping instances is just as easy, and removing them from within the pattern feature saves a lot of extra work. Onshape will allow this pattern even though some of the instances are cutting air, but it's better to remove them for design intent purposes and to make your models more resilient to design changes. Creating complex, irregular patterns is now much easier and much faster. When creating a loft, fill, or boundary surface, there is an option to show ISO curves. These help you to edit the surface to obtain the best possible quality. If the ISO curves flow nicely, your surface will generally be better. To reuse these curves for further geometry creation or modification, the new isoparametric curve can be used. You can generate equally spaced curves along the U or V direction to generate a profile for the ribs and spars along the wing. You can also generate individual curves at a percentage along the surface in the U or V directions, or select a specific point on an edge belonging to the surface. The resultant curves can be used to trim the face, generate new geometry, or as a reference for a plane or mate connector. The isoparametric curve gives you more ways to create complex designs that are more robust and with fewer construction features. The sweep feature now has a thin option. This means that you only have to draw one side of a sketch and you don't have to create all the offsets, which will save you a ton of time and effort. You can choose a single side, mid-plane, or have different offsets on both sides. Notice that the offsets trim nicely so you can get the exact geometry you need. This will make complex profiles like this simple, but also simple things like tubes even easier. Fit class tolerances can now be applied to any dimension as a fit class only, with the tolerance, or the tolerance only. Specify the desired fit type and the relevant hole and shaft designators are filtered and displayed on the right. To display both, turn on stacked visibility. The values are taken from standard tables, and when a design change occurs, the values will update automatically, removing any potential errors and saving a lot of time and effort. If you have permissions to delete a branch or workspace in a document, a dialog appears warning you that it will be deleted permanently, but not anymore, because now you can restore a deleted workspace by simply clicking on the link in the info balloon. So if you delete a workspace by accident or you change your mind, you can get it back instantly. But what if you deleted it days ago, or you want to continue on a branch that has no workspace? In the hamburger menu, top left, a new option, Restore Deleted Workspaces, opens a dialog that lists all the workspaces that have been deleted in the last 30 days, so you don't need to worry about losing any work, and it's just another example of the superior data management capabilities provided by Onshape. Action items are a great way to organize your tasks, but in order to review your to-do list, you have to come out of the document you're working in. Well, now you can access all your comments, tasks, and release notifications while working in a document in the Action Item panel on the left. The usual filters are available to make the list more manageable, and a new one filters only for the current documents, so you can see all the relevant information at a glance. Clicking on each item will expand it, and all the links to get more information are right there. Turning off the current document filter will show everything. Now you can access all your action items and create general tasks without leaving your document. The obsolescence dashboard in Onshape Enterprise generates detailed reports of all items that have been obsoleted, along with all the assemblies and drawings in which they were used. Clicking on an obsoleted item shows where it was used, but the detail is very high level, and you'd have to open each document to get a better understanding. Now, a new Where Used drill-down report has been added to each obsoleted item. This report not only tells you which document the obsoleted part is in, but also where it was referenced and in what document. You can then drill down further if you need to, making the whole process of project management much easier. Every release of Onshape includes incremental performance improvements across the board, though some improvements are more difficult to demonstrate. If you write custom features, then the performance improvements to the normalize function in this latest release will blow your mind. In this for loop of 100,000 iterations, normalizing a vector without units takes 5.43 seconds, and normalizing a vector with units takes 20.8 seconds. Now change your library version to the latest and greatest, and normalizing a vector without units takes a paltry 455 milliseconds. That's over 11 times faster. And to normalize a vector with units takes only 468 milliseconds. That's over 42 times faster than before. So if your custom features use a lot of vector math, make sure you update them to the latest version and your features will run a whole lot faster. And of course, Onshape's built-in features will be faster too.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.